Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Edgewater Waterford Baptist Circuit online service for Sunday, May 3rd, 2020. Because of the restrictions placed on public gatherings, we will be using this medium to still have our morning worship service. Welcome to everyone tuned in. Special welcome to our first-time viewers. Special welcome also to our brothers and sisters from the Waterford Baptist Church. Our leader today is Deacon Dr. Kirkland Anderson, and our preacher is our very own pastor, Reverend Dr. Dylan Toussaint. We pray God's continued blessings upon them and their families. In today's service, Holy Communion will be observed. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Our worship team will now lead us in a time of praise and worship. Please sing along with us.
We come here to praise, we come here to praise, we come here to praise the Lord. If we sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord. We come here to lift up His holy name, we come here to praise the Lord. We come to spread the gospel to the world and we come here to praise, we come here to praise, we come here to praise the Lord. If we sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord. We come here to lift up His holy name, we come here to praise the Lord. We come to spread the gospel to the world and praise the Lord. We come here to praise, we come here to praise the Lord. If we sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord. We come here to lift up His holy name, we come here to praise the Lord. We come to spread the gospel to the world and praise the Lord. We come here to praise, we come here to praise, we come here to praise the Lord. If we sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord. We come here to lift up His holy name, we come here to praise the Lord. We come to spread the gospel to the world and praise the Lord. We come here to praise, we come here to praise, we come here to praise the Lord. If we sing and shout and clap our hands and praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me. And I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am. Where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I know who God says I am. What He says I am. Where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working in miracles. I live a life of favor. Cause I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm working miracles. I live a life of favor. Cause I know who I am.
The elders and angels.
others and them just wow. The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. Holy, holy, holy are you,
Father in heaven, how we love you. We lift your name in all the earth. May your kingdom be established in our praises. As your people declare your mighty works, blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who reigns forevermore.
O God most holy, we adore you. We lay all before your throne. May the fragrance of your presence be about us as we purpose to worship you alone.
Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who was and is and is to come. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who reigns forevermore. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who was and is and is to come. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who reigns forevermore.
Blessed be the Lord.
Brothers, sisters, friends, good morning to you all. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you one and all to this our Edgewater Waterford Circuit of Baptist Churches online service. It is indeed a pleasure for all of us to be sharing God's undiluted words with you in the comfort of your homes. I would also like to take this opportunity to really encourage all of us to take comfort that despite the fact that we are locked down, despite the fact that we are shut in, we are not shut out of the kingdom of God. We know, we are assured that God's arms and heart are wide open willing and ready to receive all of us. Let us be comforted, my brothers and sisters, friends, with the words of God coming to us from Psalm 47 and verse 7. David himself says, "Rest in the Lord, rest thyself in the Lord, and wait patiently on him." May we be encouraged with the words coming to us from John 16 and verse 33. Jesus himself says that I tell you this now so that you will know that in me you will have peace. In this world you will have tribulation. But do not be discouraged because I, Jesus, have overcome the world. May we be comforted knowing fully well that this too shall pass. It is my prayers, brothers and sisters, friends, that all of us today will be blessed and God only will be glorified. It is my prayer that today all of us as Christians will be closer drawn to God, and all those who have not yet said yes to Jesus Christ will use today as an opportunity to do so. Remember, tomorrow is no guarantee. Let us pray. Most righteous Heavenly Father, the God of grace, the God of mercy, the mighty God of Daniel, Lord, this morning, today, O God, we, your children, come before you with penitent hearts. We come before you, O God, knowing, Father, that we have failed you in so many different ways. We have not loved the way that we ought to. We have not been caring the way we are supposed to. We have not done the things. We have not walked in your steps the way we ought to walk. And so, Lord, we come asking you, God, for your forgiveness. We come, O God, asking you, Lord, for another portion of your blessing, of your filling, O God. So we ask, O Lord, that you will wash us and cleanse us, O God, from all unrighteousness. We come before you, God, because we know, Lord, that you are awesome. You are a loving God. You are a mighty God. And there's nothing that is difficult for you to do. Oh God, we come before you, Father, knowing that you are our doctor. And there's no other God like you. There's no other God like you, oh God. And so we come knowing all of that, Lord. We come because we want to put before you, Jesus, the situation that has been facing this entire world, this pandemic, oh God. A situation that none of us have ever seen or witnessed in our life. But we know, God, that you are God, and this would not have happened without you allowing it. You allow it, oh God, for your glory, and we give you all the praise. We give you all the adoration, oh God. And so, Father, we put before you right now all those who have been inflicted with this virus. We know, God, that you are the antivirus. And so, Father, we pray right now, O God, that you will touch these individuals and heal them, O God. We pray in a special way, Lord, for those who have lost their loved ones, O God, that you will strengthen them. You give them encouragement. You give them peace of mind. Help them to understand that you are in charge, O God, and that you have a bigger picture. We pray, O God, for those who are on the front line. For those, the nurses, oh God, the doctors, the security forces, we pray for your wisdom to rest on all of them. That as they go through their daily tasks, that they will apply your wisdom and understanding to what they have to do. We pray for your strength. We pray, oh God, that you will strengthen them physically and spiritually. We pray, oh God, for their family members, that you will surround them also, oh God, and you will give them peace of mind and comfort. Oh God, we pray for those who are worried, who are, oh God, losing hope because they have lost their jobs. They don't know where the next meal is likely to be coming from. But help them to remember, oh God, that you are all-powerful. And that, oh God, there's no concern. There's no amount of persons that you cannot feed. And so we ask, oh God, that right now you'll reach out and provide for them, Lord. In a special way, oh God, help them to understand, Lord, that you are still in charge and you sit high and you look low. Oh God, we put them before you now, Lord. We pray, oh God, for the words that will be going forth. We ask, oh God, that you will speak to your man servant. You will speak through him. And that nothing that is spoken, oh God, will spoken of self. but it will come straight from you. And we ask, O God, that when the words go forth, that, O God, they will fall on good soil. They will fall, they will multiply, and, O God, they will bring forth, O God, a lot of success. So we put all these into your hands right now, Lord. And we pray, O God, that you'll continue to direct our paths. Continue, O God, to help us to walk in your footsteps day after day. We ask, O God, all these mercies in no other name, but in the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. We will now meditate on the word of God coming to us from the Psalms 43. Vindicate me, O God, and plead my cause against an ungodly nation. Rescue me from deceitful and wicked men. You are God, my stronghold. Why have you rejected me? Why must I go mourning, oppressed by the enemy? Send forth your light and your truth. Let them guide me. Let them bring me to your holy mountain, to the place where you dwell. Then will I go to the altar of God, to God my joy and my delight. I will praise you with the harp, O God, my God. Why you downcast, O my soul? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my God and my Savior. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We will now pause to listen to the welcome and the announcement.
Announcements. Please be in touch with your respective class leaders for information and any updates. Remember the sick and shut-ins. Please visit or call if you can and keep them in your prayers. All members and friends are asked to join in a chain of prayer, this and every Wednesday from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. Each slot is for 30 minutes. Join us as we pray for divine protection and provision. Those affected by COVID-19 and are in critical condition. Those in recovery. The ailing. The elderly and shut-ins. The speedy discovery of a safe vaccine. The health and security forces. Leaders of government, churches, and other sectors in Jamaica and across the world. Come, let us bow down before our God, who is our only source of help.
COVID-19 nutrition tips. Consume less fat, salt, sugar, alcohol, and processed foods. Consume more dietary fiber, water, fresh fruits, and vegetables daily. Eat smaller portions to maintain a healthy weight. Make use of the multi-mix principle. That is, combine foods from the different food groups to ensure meals are balanced. Reduce the use of saturated fats and include more unsaturated ones. Include more complex carbohydrates, such as yam, bananas, potatoes. Keep your immune system up. Take supplements where necessary. Keep hydrated. Drink at least 8 8-ounce glasses of water or unsweetened fruit juice every day. Keep moving. Keep stress levels low. Play. Pray. Rest. And have fun. God bless you all.
Happy anniversary to anyone celebrating wedding anniversary this week. Happy 41st anniversary to brother and sister Wilbert Murray. Many happy returns. God continued blessings on your marriage. Also, happy birthday to anyone celebrating birthday this week. Many happy returns and God's blessings be yours as well. He's a man of mystery. An interpreter of dreams. He was thrown in the lion's den.
Call upon your name.
The three Hebrew boys.
Lord, save me!
Why do they not burn?
finger writing on the wall. A book written between the 6th and the 7th century BC. It's the apocalyptic book of the Old Testament. Join the Reverend Dr. Dylan Toussaint Wednesday nights at 7:30 for The Daniel Story. A book written by Daniel himself. The Daniel Story, Wednesday nights at 7:30.
We are going to listen to the words of God coming to us, delivered by the man of God, our own pastor, Reverend Dr. Dylan Toussaint. But just before he comes to us, we're going to invite our dear sister, Sister Rochelle Dacus, to bless our hearts with a special selection. Rochelle.
The army of Judah was paralyzed by fear when they heard a mighty multitude was quickly drawing near. But as they prayed for deliverance, the victory would begin. For when we call upon the Lord, we summon all of heaven. Pray on, for you are who the Lord is looking for. Pray on, for this will tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is won. Very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. When Daniel faced the lions for worshiping the Lord, it seemed there was no hope at all for what would be in store. But where we stand on holy ground, our smallest prayer is heard. Instead of on our circumstance, our eyes are on the Lord. When your questions go unanswered and your prayers may seem in vain, they don't seem to make a difference, they don't seem to make a change, just rest assured God knows your needs and He hears each time you pray. Your prayers are reaching heaven and the answers are the way. Praying on, for you are who the Lord is looking for. Praying on, tear those mighty strongholds down. Stay on your knees, for this is where the battle is won. There's no better place for you to be. And seeking the Father prayerfully, very soon you'll win the victory. Pray on. Pray on.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Thanks again for joining our online worship service. And thanks as well to all who played a role in making it possible. Our text this morning comes to us from Psalm 42, verse 1 to 6, which of course bears much resemblance to Psalm 43, which was read earlier. Psalm 42, verse 1 to 6. As the hart or the deer panteth after the water brooks, so panteth my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night, while they continually say unto me, Where is thy God? When I remember these things, I pour out my soul in me. For I had gone with the multitude, I went with them to the house of God, with the voice of joy and praise, with a multitude that kept holy day. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him for the help of his countenance. O my God, my soul is cast down within me. Therefore will I remember thee from the land of Jordan and of the Hermonites from the hill Mizar. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now, recently, I was in a discussion with a psychiatrist and a family counselor addressing the matter of coping in the midst of a crisis. And in so doing, one of the things which became evident in that discussion is the fact that as the crisis continues, a number of persons may experience depression in some form or another. And so this morning, the focus of my message really will be on dealing with depression during difficult days. Dealing with depression during difficult days. Now, what is depression? Depression may be defined in two main ways. First of all, a feeling of severe despondency and dejection. And also, depression may be defined as a reduced ability to enjoy life. Years ago, someone who had experienced depression for some time described it as falling into a deep, dark pit that you want to get out of, but don't know how. Have you ever been there? Or are you there at this moment in a deep, dark pit of negative emotions that you want to get out of, but don't know how? In this text this morning, we find the psalmist expressing the fact that he knew what it was to be depressed. That's what he was referring to when he mentioned being cast down. Cast down. Cast down, as it were, into a deep, dark pit. Now, it's important to bear in mind that the psalmist would have been a good and godly man. Yet, he had moments of depression. You see, beloved, depression can be the experience of anyone, anywhere, anyhow, and at any time. And so, as we drill deeper into this text this morning, the following become evident. One, the reasons for the psalmist's depression. The reasons for the psalmist's depression. Now, I must acknowledge that generally speaking, persons may get depressed for all sorts of reasons. For example, the loss of a job, the loss of income, the loss of a relationship, the loss of a loved one, especially by death, the loss of one's health, the loss of one's possessions, the loss of one's peace of mind, and the loss of opportunities. And the list goes on and on. However, a careful reading of the text reveals that the psalmist, at the time of penning this psalm and Psalm 43, was experiencing not only a loss, but also a deep longing. A deep longing. A deep longing that some of you this morning may be able to relate to because of your experience. What was this longing that this psalmist was experiencing? First of all, we see that it was a longing for a closer relationship with Almighty God, found in verse 1 and verse 2. As the deer pants after the water, so my soul pants for thee, O my God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. It's a longing, beloved, for a closer relationship with Almighty God. And isn't that beautiful? And isn't that the longing of many of us this morning? Oh, for a closer walk with God. Oh, for a closer relationship with Him. That was the psalmist's longing. But it was also a longing for corporate worship in the house of God. A longing for corporate worship in the house of God. In verse 2 and verse 4, we read where he says, when shall I come and appear before God? And in verse 4, he says, when I remember these things, I pour out my soul in me. For I had gone with the multitude. I went with them to the house of God with a voice of joy and praise, with a multitude that kept holy day. According to verse 6, the psalmist was in the land of Jordan when he wrote this psalm. And for some reason, he was unable to go to the house of God as he was accustomed to. He was unable to go to the house of God with God's people to worship God. And for him, this became a depressing scenario. It's similar to what is now happening in the world, across the world, really, where there are many persons who long to go into the sanctuary, long to go to the house of God, to worship God with God's people. But because of circumstances, because of the crisis that we are all facing in this world, most, if not all of us, have to be elsewhere. That was a longing that the psalmist had. So it's a longing, deep longing, beloved, for a closer relationship with Almighty God, and a longing for corporate worship in the house of God. But my second point, the results of the psalmist's depression. The results of the psalmist's depression. Now, as the psalmist continues to share his experience in the text, the results of his depression become increasingly obvious. And in the interest of time, I will just list them before I go to the third and major point. For one, we see a sense of sadness. A sense of sadness in verse 3. He says, my tears have been my meat day and night. Have you ever felt so sad that you lose your appetite? Have you ever felt so sad, so drowned with tears, that somehow food has lost its appealing value. The psalmist was so sad because of the depression that he was going through that not even food could satisfy anymore. Also, in regards to the results of the psalmist's depression, not only do we see a sense of sadness, but there's also a sense of helplessness. Because in verse 3, he mentions that they were continually saying unto him, "Where is your God? Where is your God, O man of God? Where is the God that you have been serving? Where is the God that you have been worshiping? Where is the God in this crisis that you are facing?" And he, as it were, felt helpless because he felt as if this God was now quiet and God was not doing anything seemingly on his behalf. Have you ever felt that way? Have you ever felt a sense of helplessness in regards to God coming to your rescue when you need him most? And one of the stinging things about the question that was being asked was that the psalmist no doubt asked himself the same question. And it's a difficult thing to answer a question that you have been asking without an answer for yourself. And this was the experience of the psalmist, a result of his depression, a sense of sadness, a sense of helplessness. But also, you notice that there's a sense of restlessness. A sense of restlessness. In verse 5, he asked rhetorically, "Why art thou disquieted within me?" Have you ever felt restless? Or perhaps right now you are going through a sense of restlessness because you feel and are cooped up in your home for so many days, seeing the same faces almost 24/7. And a sense of restlessness can easily creep upon us as persons go through this crisis. And then, when we even drill further down, we see that not only was there a sense of sadness, a sense of helplessness, a sense of restlessness, but you would have surmised that there is also a sense of hopelessness. Because in the same verse 5, he says, "Hope thou in God," which points to the fact that his hope was waning, his hope was fleeting. And the psalmist had obviously lost or was losing hope. Perhaps there are some of you on the verge of giving up this morning. Already we are hearing of suicides across the world due to a sense of hopelessness as the crisis continues. And quite likely, there are those who are thinking of throwing in the towel somewhere in the world this morning, because they have lost hope. So the results of the psalmist's depression, though not exhaustive in terms of the list, as we see a sense of sadness, a sense of helplessness, a sense of restlessness, a sense of hopelessness. Are you there this morning, going through similar experiences? But you know, this psalm, Psalm 42, it doesn't end there. Because after we have seen the reasons for the psalmist's depression, and after we see the results of his depression, I'm sure you will notice with me the remedy for for the psalmist's depression. And when I say remedy, I have to put it in quotations, because this is not like some wonder drug or vaccine that you can take when you are sick or to ward off sickness. Indeed, when we talk about depression, it depends on a number of variables. And certainly for persons who are going through depression, it's normally recommended that you receive counseling from a professional individual who is trustworthy and mature. There are many variables when we think and talk about depression and how it can affect and impact the lives of people. So when I say remedy, I have to put it in quotations, because I'm actually focusing on the text and seeing how the psalmist dealt with his depression and how he found a remedy of sorts. And for that reason, I would like to share with us in closing 4 suggestions coming out of the psalmist's expressions. First of all, I'd like to suggest, be resourceful. Be resourceful. That as you go through this time of depression, feeling down and out, cast aside and cast down, it's an opportunity to be resourceful. I wonder if we notice that the psalmist put pen to paper and he wrote of his experience, his challenges, his difficulties. And that is what we have in Psalm 42 and Psalm 43. A man spending the time to write, as it were, to journal his journey. And now, thousands of years after, we are benefiting from what he wrote. In essence, beloved, he turned what seemed like his misery into a ministry. He turned his test into a testimony. He turned his obstacles into opportunities. And one of the things about every crisis, somebody once said, a crisis is a terrible thing to waste. That even as you go through this time of the depression, it's good to journal your journey. It's good to share with others of your experiences, so that those who may be going through it or will go through it might benefit from knowing that you have been there, done that, and God has pulled you through. Be resourceful. But secondly, in terms of remedy, I'd like to suggest, be willful. Be willful. You have to be willing and have willpower to fight this thing, to ward off this thing, to defeat this thing, to overcome this thing known as depression. You'll notice, beloved, that the psalmist, again in verse 5, he, speaking to himself now, says, "Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou disquieted within me?" He is talking to himself as he's challenging himself and asking himself some important questions so that he can reflect on his situation. And then hear him saying, "Hope thou in God." He's speaking to himself willfully, challenging himself to hope in God. And in other psalms, we find psalmists doing the same thing, I will call upon the Lord. I will rejoice. I will declare. All of those are willful statements which are saying, I have to fight this thing. I have to speak to myself about this thing. And I have to deal with this thing with every ounce of strength that I have. Being willful may mean that you may have to rebuke and reverse the negative thoughts and the negative talk. Being willful may mean, as the psalmist did, that you have to repeat yourself. You will note that this statement in verse 5 is repeated in the rest of chapter 42 and repeated in chapter 43. The same words. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God. And he says it again. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God. And in chapter 43, he says it again. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou disquieted within me? Hope thou in God. It's willpower. You have to fight it with every ounce of strength you have. Or else it will defeat you and destroy you. Thirdly, may I suggest that along with being resourceful and being willful, remain prayerful. Remain prayerful. And one of the beautiful things about this psalm and Psalm 43 is that they are a prayer. They constitute a prayer. That this man who is struggling with depression, speaking to his God in prayer, pouring out his heart, his soul, his thoughts, his emotions to God, being honest and open with God, we find him in prayer. And that's what prayer is about. And the one prayer we pray. We pray in a night and we pray in a day. And there are times when you have to not only deal with your issues and your challenges in prayer before God with a one prayer, but you have to do it time and time again. But in all of that, be open, be honest. Be truthful as you speak to God. And understand that the answer to your prayer may not come overnight. But if God permits, it will come over time. But continue to pray. And finally, in terms of the remedy, not only from the text do we see the importance of being resourceful and being willful. Not only do we see the importance of remaining prayerful, but may I close with this. Remain worshipful. Remain worshipful. In the same verse 5, the psalmist goes on to say, I shall yet praise him for the help of his countenance. I shall yet praise him. Put another way, yet still I will praise him. Put another way, regardless of what is happening, I am committed to praising God, to worshiping God. You see, beloved, the psalmist realized even more that yes, there is something beautiful, special and meaningful about going to the house of God with God's people to worship God in spirit and in truth. But more and more he realized, beloved, that no matter where he was, no matter what he was going through, he was still able to worship God. Because worship is not confined in the four walls of a church building. Worship is everything we do anywhere we are to the God that we serve. And that is why, beloved, the church really is not about the building. The church, the called out people of God who serve God and worship Him regardless of where we are. And so the psalmist remained worshipful. He said almost defiantly, "Yet I will worship, I will praise you, I will exalt you." In the midst of my depression, as difficult as it is, I will find songs to sing unto you and words to praise you, because it could be worse. And isn't that true, beloved? It could be worse no matter what is happening. It could be worse. So, I don't know who this word is for this morning. But if it is for you, if it is for somebody that you know that is going through depression, we can learn that in spite of the reasons, in spite of the results, there is still a remedy. Be resourceful. Be willful. Be prayerful. Remain worshipful. Amen.
So my soul longeth after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You alone are my strength, my shield. You alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. You're my friend, and you are my brother, even though you are a king. I love you more than any other, so much more than anything. You alone are my strength, my shield. To you alone may my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee. I want you more than gold or silver, only you can satisfy. You alone are the real joy giver and the apple of my eyes. You strength, my shield. To you alone my spirit yield. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship Thee, and I long to worship Thee, Lord, I long to worship
Thee. So as we come to this sacred table this morning, we come because the Lord bids us to come. We come as an act of fellowship, and we come as an act of worship. And as we come, we hear the words of our Lord saying to us again, I am the bread of life, and he who comes to me will never be hungry, and he who believes in me will never be thirsty. And so the Lord Jesus Christ, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took the bread, and he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also, he took the cup. And he said, this cup is a new covenant in my blood. Whenever you drink of it, do so in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat the bread and drink from the cup, we do show the Lord's death until he comes. And so, the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which was broken for us, let us eat and be thankful. Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which was shed for us, let us drink. Lord, we thank you again for this opportunity to worship you wherever we are. We thank you, Lord, that in spite of what we are facing across the world, we still have access to you. We thank you, God, that as the deer pants for the water, so our soul continues to long after you. And you alone are our strength, our shield. And we continue to worship you. Lord, for those who are going through depression of any sort, in any form, I pray now, Lord God, for your hand of healing to rest upon them. Take off in the name of Jesus the garment of depression and put on the garment of praise. Thank you now for hearing our prayers as you deliver your people and as you continue to strengthen your people. We continue to worship you in spirit and in truth, for truly you are worthy to be praised. And so now may grace, mercy, and peace from Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest, remain, and abide with us and God's people everywhere, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you for joining us. We hope you will join us again as we worship together. Please remember to pray for each other and maintain the required social distance. There is power in prayer. Have a blessed week in the Lord.